We have more black women, right, graduating from college, 2 to 1 to black men. You throw in incarceration rates, you throw in the unemployment rates, and you're saying there's just not enough black men.
Well, there are not enough black men for all of the college-educated black women in particular that have the type of husbands that they want to have.
The type that they want to have. Now, I put this out, and we had this conversation yesterday, and a lot of people were chiming in, and I decided to ask for questions from viewers. And one of the questions, simply put, is, do black women deserve better than what black men have to offer? That seems like a very heavy question there, but is that essentially what it is? Do we not measure up to the quality of black women right now?
That's really a great way to put it, and I will admit that I usually think about it from the other perspective, which is that is it fair to ask black women to sacrifice their own happiness on the altar, as it were, of black men's struggles?
And what?
Okay, I think not.
What is that?
I think not.
Okay, what's that sacrifice necessarily when we're talking about, and I asked you this question yesterday, is it always marrying down if the person you're marrying doesn't make as much money or have the same level of education? Could be a good guy.
Yeah, he could be a good guy, and lots of relationships work across classes, that's true. But it's also the case that for everyone, not simply for the women, but for the men as well, having a spouse who is matched to you educationally in terms of your outlook, your aspirations, your experiences, that's a positive thing. So it's actually not a great thing for the wife or the husband if they're in a mismatched relationship.
All right, and we know a lot of conversations were started yesterday because of this topic, and I had one of these conversations at my house with Mrs. Holmes, and one of these things that keeps coming up is how do you, and the word I think my wife used was reprogram, if you will, black women, because you're suggesting they need to be open to dating outside of their race. But, you know, a lot of black women just like brothers. They like a black man.
Right.
So if you're just not attracted naturally, why have them give up on finding a black man?
Right. That's a great question. And the issue, the way I think of that is that women have been asked to carry a great load. Black women shoulder a lot of the burden, in short, of black men's struggles. And I am asking women to put the burden down. Many women think that they're attracted to black men. They are attracted to black men. But attraction itself is complicated. And one of the things that I discovered in the course of writing this book is that there's a whole host of fears and desires and anxieties that animate black women's attraction to black men.
Okay. And on that, though, I got another question from a viewer. Judy sent in and said, well, it sounds like you're saying, why should black women give up the good fight? You know, you're not telling them to take on a project of fixing a man necessarily, but why just give up on black men?
Right. That is another great question. I actually am asking black women to give up the good fight because
give up the good fight
hasn't been successful. The fight has not been successful. This is what a friend of mine, Carolyn Edgar, calls a Negro Improvement Project, which is what a lot of black women undertake. And often the results are not so great. So the strategy has been counterproductive. It doesn't help African-Americans for us to have black men and black women locked in bad relationships and raising children in households where the parents quarrel and ultimately divorce. Well, that's not a win for anyone.
It is law professor Ralph Richard Banks. The book is called Is Marriage for White People? I think it went on sale on the 2nd this week, and it has started a conversation that I'm sure will continue.